Hello, my name is Razalia Amirova. I'm from Innopolis University. My supervisor is Giancarlo Succi, and I will present my work named Attention Tracking for Developers.
Field. Code and new ideas are born in the brains of programmers, so it is very important to monitor its functional state. One way to improve the quality of developers' work is to help them to concentrate better. Timely detect a drop in concentration and brain fatigue, which could be done by controlling the level of attention during programming. In order to contribute to the development of this field, for the current work, we formulated and answered the following research questions. For my work, I stated and answered the following three research questions. First is, what methods do exist to estimate the attention level during coding? The second is, can the change of the level of attention during programming be measured using EEG? And the third is there the possibility to identify correlations between attention levels and types of mental activity, assuming that the attention level is measured using EEG devices? First of all, I want to describe what is EEG itself. EEG, or electroencephalography, is a method to record electrical activity of the brain. It is typically non-invasive, with the electrodes placed along the scalp. Each electrode records its own channel. As a background, we performed a systematic literature review. We selected 40 from 317 analyzed publications. We done it together with my colleagues, and the results were published in a conference. Questions answered by the literature review. How biophysical signals were used in determining the condition of human activity or work? In the framework of RQ1, how EEG was used? What kind of EEG analysis techniques were used? And how attention and stress level were studied during programming? The main question answered by the systematic literature review was what methods do exist to estimate the attention level during coding. We found out that there are a lot of methods, for example, heart rate variability, galvanic skin response, pupil diameter, eye blink frequency, brain activity measurement, EEG, MEG, fNRIs, ECOG, fMRI, and many others. Some of the methods are less accurate, some of them are more. Some of them are difficult to apply in real condition during programming. We found out that EEG is one of the most promising because it provides an ability to study the functional state of the core of the nervous system, brain, and could be used in a real environment since it is portable. Then we formulated hypotheses and conducted an experimentation sessions to test them. Our hypotheses were: level of attention during programming can be measured using EEG. A relationship between types of mental activity and an attention level could be investigated using data captured by EEG. There is a specific pattern of brain activation during programming which could be seen in EEG data. For the experimentation, we used 24-channel wireless EEG Smart BCI cap and EEG Studio by Mitsar. As a preparations, the main points were cleaning the device, putting gel, verification electrodes, and then we followed strict protocol, which main steps were calibration with open and closed eyes, subject reads tasks, subject solved the task, taking off cap and cleaning cap. Participants of the experimentations were 9 students of Innopolis University. All subjects were 21 years old, except for one, who is 22. All subjects were bachelor-level students of 4th form. We asked their programming level and preferred task difficulty. 62% of participants solved the task. We asked how comfortable it was to work while recording the EEG and what could be improved to improve the process in the future. Then I've done pre-processing steps, This is a very important point for AG data, since the experiment was carried out in real conditions, which means it was subject to noise. First of all, I chose the right channels. This means the choice of electrodes, the data from which will be processed. The choice of channels is always a trade-off between the quantity and the quality of data. The central electrodes were chosen because they are the most accurate, since the electrodes fit more tightly and more complete, as they capture the most interesting parts of the brain. Then I tried to eliminate all the interference and corrupted parts of the recordings. This stage is called artifact detection. I did it both automatically with the help of the EEG studio and manually, where I saw sharp and unreal fluctuations. Then I filtered the data using notch filter to clean from AC lines and low-pass and high-pass filters to get the data from interested bands. Then I performed results and analysis. I found out that in the second half of each recording, theta band tends to increase, whereas alpha band decreases. Higher difference of theta and alpha between halves of the recordings means a higher level of mental workload, attention, and task difficulty. Compared to open source driving dataset, I found out that theta band for both programming and driving is higher than alpha relatively to other bands, which is a signal of higher level of mental concentration. For programming, the difference between theta and alpha is much higher than for driving, which means a higher level of mental workload, attention, and task difficulty. The value of upper alpha band relatively to other values for driving is higher than for programming, which is a signal of higher semantic memory process.
As a result of my work, I can draw a conclusion that the level of attention during programming could be measured using EEG by tracking alpha and theta bands. These facts in the future allow us to build a system for monitoring the level of attention, which can be used to improve the quality of work and detect fatigue. It could help to prevent diseases associated with overwork. Also, there are specific patterns of functional state of the brain comparing to other type of mental activity, driving. A deeper study of specific neuron activation patterns can be used to build human-machine interfaces. Thank you for your attention.